Once upon a time, she stole pages from fairy tales and wrapped her perception of herself in these carbon copy, fictional characters only so that she could appear more readable to the masses. So check her out now. She's a library. She's a story. She's a wannabe storyteller. Telling trumped up stories to grace your timeline because it makes her feel better about herself. I said it makes her feel better about herself. Yeah. Here we go. I remember my first time. He was tall and light-skinned. I think his name was like, something like David Johnson. He played high school ball, drove this nice convertible car, and y'all, he loved me just the way that I needed him to. He was my first made-up boyfriend, and y'all, he did everything that I told him to. Like, I even had this random picture to whip out just in case if anyone spotted holes in my tall tales, because my tall tale couldn't stand being left out of another, ooh, girl, we gotta talk conversation. No, my tall tale and my weak spine couldn't stand being left on the shelf for too long, so borrow me, listen, just check me out now. She stole pages from fairy tales and handcrafted this expectation for life that was so far from reality that even she had to make believe to make others believe that her confidence was real. Nah, see, her facade was merely a smokescreen for blocking out hours of staring herself in the mirror and yet still only finding all of the blemishes because makeup couldn't cover girl and natural filters couldn't conceal her insecurities. You can tell it by the way her eyes shadow. Her foundation was faulty at its best. My foundation was faulty at its best. There was a leak in that old building and my soul did not know how to move. But oh, I remember my first time. It was a small apartment near the north side of Columbia. I stood tall, swallowed what seemed to be the biggest knot in my throat, and for the first time I quoted, I am fearfully and wonderfully made.
Say so.
And no, I did not feel any chains break off of me immediately, but I do know that they were at least loosened, and so daily I began to remind myself of this truth, and daily I began to uncover a beauty not found in fairy tales. I uncovered a storyline with a plot that finally satisfied my soul in Him. In God's word, I finally found me. Question. Have you ever felt like maybe you didn't measure up?
Think about it.
Like maybe you weren't good enough. Not smart enough. Not strong enough. Not big enough. Heck, not small enough. Maybe you were the one with the big feet. Listen, I rep a size 10 and a half.
You know you got a big feet.
Maybe you were too short. Maybe you were ashamed at where you lived or ashamed at where you worked. Perhaps you were the one in the crew with that natural 4C hair type whose tightly coiled curls, aka nappy, nah, aka good hair, defied even those relaxers with lie is no lie. We live in a society where men pay a premium for perfection, where we laugh and criticize the virgin, but pluck scriptures out the book, discard it, and then sell it as a new version. There's no wonder why stem cells started converting. We are more than gemstones. We have got to stop conforming. I am just an alarm, and this is just a warning. You won't ever be the best you are trying to be someone else. Normal is so overrated. We insult the Creator when we don't embrace ourselves. And no, I'm not talking about ditching God and placing ourselves on the throne. I'm talking about acknowledging that you were born you on purpose. And that in and of itself is all good.
It's all good.
I'm talking about canning those freaking little lights and then reflecting the sun with no reservations. Divert from the script. Shatter all the plot twists. Be you. Make every reader's neck twist. You are a story that should never be missed. But even if someone misses it,
you go.
You should never lose yourself trying to make someone else get it. Everybody won't get you. And that's okay because it doesn't make you any less valuable. So stop stealing pages from other people's fairy tales. Divert from the script. Shatter all the plot twists. Be you. Make every reader's neck twist. You are a story that should never be missed. God made you a story. You are a freaking good story. So open up, be you, and let him read you.
end.